forging IT. Forging IT security experts. Secure Ninja.
Hey everybody, I'm Alicia Webb with SecureNinjaTV, and I'm here at RSA 2013 in San Francisco. I'm here at the Mandiant booth talking with Richard Bejtlich, and he is the Chief Security Officer of Mandiant. How are you today?
I'm great, Alicia.
Thank you so much for speaking with us.
Thank you.
Mandiant's kind of a big deal right now, which is awesome. Mandiant's always a big deal. But one of the big topics was the recent Chinese hacker report that you guys published, which got so much media attention, which is so awesome. Tell me about it.
Well, Mandiant released a report on one of the groups that we track. We call this group internally APT1, and what we did was we linked the activity of that group to an actual People's Liberation Army unit. They have a cover name of 61398, but they're actually part of the PLA, and we were able to say this group that we've seen working since 2006 is this PLA unit located outside of Shanghai.
Amazing. So what were you able to uncover that wasn't?
Well, this group that we've been tracking, we found that they've compromised about 141 companies. These are companies that Mandiant's helped over that 7-year period. We found that they had stolen data from these companies, that it affected 20 different industries. And this is a group that's very prolific. They've been working now for many years against many different targets. And we thought it was time to let the world know what this group was doing and to not just say it was an anonymous group of hackers, but to say, look, this is an actual military unit that is conducting this activity, and that it's not really fair to have a military unit hacking civilian companies. They're just not equipped to deal with that kind of challenge.
Absolutely, I agree, that is not fair. Now, what exactly was in the video? I mean, I've seen it, I'm sure a lot of our viewers have seen it, but give us a rundown, what was done?
Yeah, so in addition to releasing the main body of the report, we also had a second report that was all of the tools that the intruders used. And then the third piece of evidence that we released included video. And the video showed Chinese intruders working on victim computers. And there's been some controversy, did we fake this, is it real? It's real activity. These are real computers on Western organizations. That's why they're running Windows, that's why it's English language when you see the screen. And the intruders are taking different actions to send email, to check their email, to connect to other computers, to try their tools. These are the sorts of things that if you had been on those computers yourself, you would have seen the Chinese intruders doing.
Right. How do you think the Chinese hacking group, APT1, is going to react to your report?
Well, years ago I was in the military, and if I had been on the receiving end of a report like this, I know my commander would have been very upset. I imagine that they don't like being outed by a private security company. They, just culturally, they're not interested in having anybody point the finger at them and say, hey, stop this.
Right.
So I would say that they are not happy with us. And while they have changed their activity in the last week since they released the report, we do expect some more, I don't know if retribution is the right word, but we do expect some more activity directed towards Mandiant in the coming months.
Right. And how are you prepared to defend yourself against that?
Well, at Mandiant, we use a combination of our own services and products to defend ourselves. Plus, I have a security team. As the Chief Security Officer, it's my responsibility to try to protect Mandiant.
Yeah.
So we use a combination of network-based tools and host-based tools, and then people that pay attention to this sort of stuff. One of the things we're good at, I think, at Mandiant is monitoring and keeping staying vigilant. So that's what the instructions to the team is, to keep a close eye on what's happening. We've already seen these groups try to phish us, to try to send us malicious emails so they could break into Mandiant and steal information from us. So we're just going to try to stay vigilant in the coming months.
Besides their response, APT1's actual response, what kind of effect do you think outing them like this will have on their operations?
That's a really good question. That gets to the reason why we released the report. We wanted the world to change the conversation from one of sort of mythical, ghostly Chinese hackers possibly doing activity to these are real people doing real activity. There's no debate. Let's talk about now what to do about it. Not if it's happening, but because it's happening, what do we do next? So that's what we've seen. At the policy level in the government, we're already being asked, what should we do about this? You see some action from the president with the executive order. So it's a lot more now, what do we do about it, and not just debating whether or not this is an issue.
Right, and it definitely brings awareness to the issue of IT security and how important of an issue it is, and how much companies really do need to protect themselves.
That's true, and it's one of these things where it doesn't affect everybody. We're not trying to scare the world and say everyone is a potential victim of this type of intruder. But for the companies that are affected, for years they've wanted to say something. And
right.
it takes a very brave organization to come forward and say, this happened to us. Only a few have done it. The New York Times was the most recent one. RSA did it. Google did it. But there are hundreds, if not thousands, of other companies who have had this problem. But they just don't want to stand up and say that it's happened to them. So at Mandiant, we thought we could be an advocate for the victims. We could try to change the game a little bit by saying, this is what happened. And then hopefully, if we could just get the Chinese to tone it down a little bit, right. It would help quite a bit.
Absolutely. Well, high five for Mandiant.
Thank you.
For standing up and exposing this. This is definitely a good thing. Now, will there be any follow-up on Mandiant's part to this issue?
We're contemplating releasing some type of either a blog post or maybe a mini report over the next few months. We already did a briefing here at RSA where our CEO and one of our directors talked about what we've seen the adversary do in the last week. And there's been some interesting research done by some other security companies about what they've seen. So we're thinking of trying to tie all that together, maybe put in APT1 a month later, 2 months later, 6 months later, something like that. We don't plan to release reports on other groups, though, at this point. We felt like we made the point we needed to with this one report. But I think other companies and other organizations would be interested to know what happens when you tell Chinese hackers what they're doing to you. And we'll see if... We'll see what we can say about that.
Right. Do you think some other companies will come forward with what's happened to them?
Well, we've seen some newspapers say that they've had this problem. And then recently there's been several technology companies come forward and they've said they've had intrusions, not necessarily linked to the Chinese, but to other matters. Honestly, I think that we need to get to the point where there's no stigma associated with being a victim of this activity.
Right.
It's more about how you handle it and not the fact that it happened. So
absolutely.
Hopefully that'll change in the coming years too.
Definitely. Now, you've had some criticism about the validity of your report. How have you guys been able to assure the public that the information is legit?
Well, our intel team who put together the report is staffed by professionals who have been doing this for many years. Most of them are former law enforcement, intelligence community, and so forth. So they use that training and background they had to put the report together. What I would say is that since the report came out, we've had some independent analysis of the conclusions and found corroborating evidence, like an apartment listing associated with one of the intruders 600 meters away from this building in the report. We've had some others take a look at it. For example, both the House Intelligence Committee and the Senate Intelligence Committee, the chair people of both of those committees have said, we got it right. And even General Hayden, who was formerly the NSA director and the CIA director, said it was a wonderful report. So we feel like we got it right, even though we wrote the report using unclassified sources, using our own data derived from doing our own work. So I think it's good that when we did our work and the intelligence community that has access to classified sources says, yeah, we got it right, we feel pretty good about the conclusions.
Definitely. They backed you up. That's awesome.
Right.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much for speaking with us. This is definitely the interview we wanted to get here at RSA. We wanted to find out all the details, so we appreciate it.
Thanks, Alicia. I really appreciate your time.
Excellent. And everyone at home, make sure you don't miss anything going on here at RSA. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/SecureNinja, as well as like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter, because we tweet out all of the great interviews that we've been doing here at RSA. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Alicia Webb.
Secure Ninja Shorts are brought to you by SecureNinja.com, a world leader in information security and IT training and certification. Our master instructors will help build you into a highly skilled and marketable security professional. SecureNinja.com, forging IT security experts.